In mathematics, we often solve for x, but what about y? Today, let's talk about why a squared plus b squared equals c squared, or in other words, why does the Pythagorean theorem work? This theorem is probably something you've memorized in school, but I want to go behind the scenes and really investigate why does a squared plus b squared equal c squared? Just as a disclaimer, this is only one of many proofs of the Pythagorean theorem, so if you're interested in this video and want to see some other ways we can visualize this, be sure to check out the other videos on my channel. As a refresher, the Pythagorean theorem only works on right triangles, so let's get a right triangle up here. We'll go ahead and label our sides. We have this green side we can call A, this blue side which we can call B, and the hypotenuse, which is the longest side of the triangle, we can call C. So the Pythagorean theorem says if we take each of the legs, or the shorter sides of the triangle, square them and add them together, we will get the same value as taking the hypotenuse and squaring it. Now, just for fun, let's make four copies of our triangle and arrange them in a way so that it makes a square. Now, we know that this is a square because these are all right triangles, so each of these corners form each of the right angles of the square. And we know that each of the sides are the same length because they each consist of a green piece and a blue piece. Or in other words, each side has the length A plus B. Now you probably also noticed that this smaller square has formed in the center, consisting of sides of length C. Now we could assume that this is a square just by looking at it and knowing that all four sides have the same length, but let's go a step further and prove that these angles are all 90 degrees to actually prove it is a square and not just a rhombus. Remember that all of the angles in a triangle must add up to be 180 degrees. Now in our case, since we have a right triangle, we already know that one of those angles equals 90 degrees. So the other two angles, with this kind of smaller angle and this more medium-sized angle, must add up to equal 90 degrees. So if we look here, where these three angles come together to form a straight line, we also know that those three angles add up to be 180 degrees because they form a straight line. So if we have this smaller angle and this medium angle, which we know must add up to be 90 degrees, then we know that 180 minus these two angles gives us this angle of our assumed square. So 180 minus 90 does in fact equal 90, so that proves that this center square really is in fact a square. Okay. What's the point? We have one big square with a smaller square inside of it and a bunch of triangles. How is this related to the Pythagorean theorem? Just hang on with me for a second. Let's talk about area. We know that the area of a square is equal to the length of its side square. But in our case, we also know that the area of this total square would be equal to the area of all of its pieces added together. So the area of this big square also equals the area of the four triangles plus the area of the center square. So what is the area of this big square? If you remember earlier, we noticed that the length of each side was A plus B. So the area of this whole square would be A plus B squared. To find the area of the four triangles, we can look at just one triangle, and we know that the area of a triangle is equal to 1/2 times base times height. So in our case, we would have 1/2 times A times B. It doesn't matter whether you do A times B or B times A, depending which way you're looking at the triangle, either one could be the base, and we know that multiplication is commutative, so it doesn't matter which order we do it in. But we have four of these triangles, so we will multiply that area by four. Then adding in the area of the center square, that would simply be plus c squared. So we have this statement that is true. We have the total area of everything equals the sum of the area of the parts that it's made of. So just simplifying through with algebra, We know that a plus b quantity squared equals a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. And on the other side of our equation, we can simplify this to 2ab plus c squared. We have 2ab on both sides, so those will cancel out. We can subtract a 2ab from both sides and get rid of it. And that leaves us with, what do you know? A squared plus b squared equals c squared. So that's why the Pythagorean theorem works. Now, instead of memorizing it, you understand visually why a squared plus b squared equals c squared for right triangles.